Welcome to my tank, Top City Fishing Tank. I've got a 20-gallon tank here. Obviously, I can't keep these fish in here for too long, but while they're really small, I'm going to try. I got my cucumber on a fork for my pleco and my goldfish. I crawled out of here trying to get the hell out of here. Got my bass. It's pretty awesome. And I got two new additions to the tank. I got two small bluegill, but they're in the back. They're chilling. They're back there. You can kind of see them moving around. There's one. The other one's behind the rock. But eating my dead fish.
Where's the dead fish at?
Over in the corner. This bass is so cool. Kind of funny how the fish play in the bubbles. My two bluegill are out. But they all like to go towards the bubbles, the oxygen, and play in it. Alright, I'm feeding goldfish black beans, but you gotta take the skin off, because if you don't take the skin off, they can't digest it very well, but they seem to like it. You can do the same thing with peas. You just gotta take the skin off of those too. And giving them bread too. Of course, you know they're gonna eat the bread. The crawdad loves bread. I try to put bread in there. He always goes in and gets it. I'm gonna remove this stuff. I don't want the goldfish going up and gulping it off the top of the surface, because it'll give them air bubbles in their stomach. But I'm about to give them my bluegill some worms too. I just want to make sure they had enough to eat them. Boom. Make sure they had enough to eat. Well, my fork's gone. My cauliflower, can't even talk, cucumbers are gone. Bluegill is demolishing this worm. Water clarity's a little cloudy. I'll have to change it this weekend. I'm doing something wrong. I have to go back to the drawing board and figure out what I'm doing wrong here. But they all look really healthy. They all are moving around good and look strong. Guy's pissed. He's like, leave me alone, motherfucker. So I'm hiding back here. Get out of here. Lugo's like, that's mine. He's like, gotcha, bitch, I'm hungry. doing it. Eat it. Do it again. That didn't take long. The final piece of the puzzle. I had to go buy more minnows. This fool keeps devouring them.
Got me feeling kinda tipsy. Got my brother Pure Chris with me. We got history. I'ma always ride for my dog like
feeding time, baby. A big bluegill. Smolishing that worm. This one scared of it. That's my bass. I need to wipe the outside of my tank. My bass. Damn bluegill won't stop gnawing at it. But I got the bass about a month ago out of a pond using my cast net. It's pretty cool. There's my pleco. That thing goes in the cave. I got a crawdad in there. I don't know where the other one is. He gonna eat that one. Orale. My boy loves him some shrimp. He's going to town. Oh, nice hiding. He knows I'm videotaping him. A bass. What up, y'all? I started the tank a while back, but I was trying to figure out what to do. I have messed around with what these guys can eat and what they like to eat and stuff, so I've finally started to get comfortable making a video, but there's my, I have two bluegill. It's the bigger one there. That's Nacho. He's a bully. I have two goldfish in here and he's ate both of them. But I have little minnows in here and he's picking on everybody. I can't decide if I'm going to keep him or not. Because he won't stop picking on everybody else. There's my largemouth bass. He's not really large, but that's Ignacio. He's awesome, man. He freaking devours these little minnows. They're the same size as him, almost half the size of him, and he just nails them. I have a crawdad back there. He's huge. His name's Jesus. He's back there just chilling by the bubbles. And that's my small bluegill. His name's Chewy. But he kind of chills over there by the heater and the vent. So he kind of minds his own business. Not until Nacho comes around and messes with him. He usually just chills up in the bubbles. And then I have my plek, my pleko. And his name is Ramses. So Ramses is just chilling in the brushes there. What up, homie? He's like, will you film it again? He's very friendly. Orale Chewy. He's awesome. But yeah, so I've been using minnows mostly to feed these guys. So that seems what they like the best. They will eat these krill, but they don't eat it all the time. So I try not to give it to them too much because it'll get in the bottom and dissolve and make the tank cloudy. The crayfish back there, Jesus, he likes to eat frozen shrimp. So I'll have shrimp I have in the freezer. I chop it up into small pieces and give him a piece every now and then. And he likes that a lot. And then my pleco, I have him, I give him the algae wafers once every other day, and he tends to just do his thing along the side of the tank. But I'm going to keep you guys updated on my tank, and I'll tune in next time it's time to feed these guys. And hopefully these minnows, they're not really interested right now, but they'll be gone pretty soon. And the next time I feed them, I will tune in and we'll have you guys watch, because it is awesome. Ignacio, for as small as he is, he freaking nails those minnows, and it's so fun to watch. Of course, Nacho, big one. He's a tank, dude. I'm hoping to get one right now, but they just don't really seem to be interested, which sucks. And sorry for the way I talk. I tend to think as I'm talking, so I kind of talk like this a lot. Super annoying. You can blast me in the comments. I don't care. You moving in, you grooving, you better do your thing. You wanna have it sex and you wanna wear the chain. I just wanna ride with you. I just wanna ride with you. What are we gonna do? I just wanna slide up in. I just wanna ride with you. Oh yeah, baby. Where are we going? Where are we going? She wanna wear the chain and drink a bottle of Hennessy. They ask you who your man, baby girl. You just mentioned me. Keep it real.